2007, I was preparing a group of young high school kids to come visit the States for a month. And when I told the kids, I shared my story about why I was running for a public office in Kenya that year. And when they came to the States, they were having discussions about whatever they were talking about here. And a young girl in the group asked a young Kenyan man, why is it that you don't hear when we speak? Why is it that young boys don't hear when girls speak, or men when women speak? And the boy said, I don't have enough voices of women to hear when they speak from places of authority. I hear men, and I'm used to men being in places of authority, but I haven't had women. So unless we have more women like Dr. Karambu, who go out there and speak, we will not know how to hear, to listen to you. Number two, the United Nations Security Council Resolution 1325 was passed in 2000. This year is the 10th year. Kenya is right now preparing its national action plan. I was presenting to a class here yesterday. The whole class, young girls and young men, had not heard of the UN Resolution 1325. And Resolution 1325 is the resolution that requires governments to ensure that women are included in all decision-making levels in peace-building initiatives in their countries and internationally. And so I borrow from Paul Redelap's Moral Imagination. He says that moral imagination is the capacity to imagine something rooted in the challenges of the real world, yet capable of giving back to that which does not exist. I come from a community that totally erases the voice of women. And if you have a boy like this one saying, we don't know how to hear you, and we are living in a community where women don't even know what to call themselves, you're talking about changing, shifting mindsets about how culture, socialization, hegemony, ideology, all those things have shaped who we are, how we listen and hear other people speak who are not like us. And so the problem of the Kenyan conflict scenario is based on those issues that I'm not going to belabor in this presentation, because I'm going to talk about them in the other presentation. However, these are some of the things that affect or are the cause of the scenario through which the project that I've created with regards to women is based. But looking at the UN Security Resolution 1325, I use it, I look at it as a policy tool to advance women's participation in shaping Kenya's peace and security agenda, and a framework to remind policymakers of their obligations as specified in the resolution, and keep them attentive to issues of women and peace, women, peace, and security. That's at that level. But what about for women? Earlier on in a session that we had here, we heard about interventions on democracy and sustainable peace at the policymaking level. This tool is meant to enable governments and policymakers to actually own the mandate of women are an important constituent in peace building and creating sustainable peace in our countries. The gap here is Kenya hasn't created a national action plan, but women who are supposed to be enabled or empowered to speak for themselves have no clue that this thing happens. Well, if the government hasn't created a national action plan, what is happening at the bottom? And so with regard to the government requirement, with regard to signing on to the resolution, is to promote participation of women in decision making and peace processes, integration of gender perspectives and training in peacekeeping, and protection of women and gender mainstreaming. And so what I'm doing here is I'm laying the basis for which the government has a role to play in institutionalizing this tool that is the one tool that the UN has recognized as the need for giving women voice in peace building and decision-making processes.